Are you looking for ways to quickly create a PDF from any document that you store on your Google Drive folder? Then look no further, we can do it with automation. There's no need to do it all manually, to do it one by one. We can quickly create dynamic PDFs with the help of automation in make.com. Let's look at it step by step how to exactly do this. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of techflow.ai and we love automation. In this video, I'm going to show you the exact steps how you can quickly create, generate any kind of PDF with the help of automation in make.com and create dynamic PDFs, download them, upload them somewhere else, store them somewhere and make them in a PDF format so they can't be changed anymore. If you're looking to improve your skills with automation, check out the description below this video where we share a lot more about the opportunities that we are offering, the free resources that we are sharing just to get you kickstarted on your automation journey. So let's jump right into it. What we are going to do is to transform this Google document into a PDF file. Of course, you could download it as a PDF, but we want to do this on autopilot and we're using make.com for this. If you don't have a Make account yet, make sure to check out the description. We have our affiliate link there, which offers you 10,000 operations for free for a full month. And you can test out any kind of automation you can imagine. And it would support us providing more content in this channel. So thank you very much for using that. And now let's dive into the actual specifics of this setup. We download the document with the Google Docs download document module and we are using the type PDF. You can download it in a different format, docx, odt, which is the open document format, and any other kind of format that is available over here. And then we upload it to a different location as a file. And that's already it for the main very basic concept. So let's look at what the output looks like. We're uploading it into a sample folder over here. And this is the finally created PDF document from our raw Google Docs. So this is like a not transformable format anymore, or like a PDF format that you can send somewhere and create. Now, of course, we want to take it to the next level and make it actually dynamic. And therefore, we have a very simplified customer database like this one over here. We have a first name, last name, title, company, and so on. And an email address. And now we want to create a document dynamically based on this data. So each row should become a specific document. And then we want to transform that into a PDF file. So this is our template. We have like the header at the top, the name, the title, company, address, and the country, and then the salutation and the last name. In that case, we would generate like a dynamic letter, but it can be anything. It can be like an invoice. It can be hourly report or whatever you can imagine. You can create any document here dynamically. All you have to do is put your variables in curly braces here. You can even make them bold or something like that and format them. And then the variable will be replaced with your dynamic value in the end. So in that case, we want to replace all these values here in curly braces with our actual dynamic values. Now, once you have prepared your document in that way, we're going back into Make and looking at this scenario. First, we want to get the data from our Google Sheet, so the dynamic data. In that case, we're using a filter to simply get out one row, which is where the first name is equal to my name. So we're just working with one sample data, but we could also remove that filter and would work through all rows available in that Google Sheet and create one document for each row. Now, the next step is to create a document from a template. So you're selecting that module and then we're selecting the file and it will dynamically load all the variables that you put into that Google Doc for you to fill out. So customer's name, customer's title, and so on. That is exactly the value that we put here in the curly braces. And now we can just click into the field and select it from our Google Sheet database to make it dynamic. And then down here, you can also give it a title. I also like to always give it like a date, for example, or make it a unique title. And how you can work with these kind of functions, we're having a cheat sheet for that, which is completely free. just check out the description below this video. You can download it for free, which tells you everything about these make functions, which are super powerful, handy, and can transform your data, can transform dates, dynamically insert the dates, like in that case, and really can save you a ton of operations. So make sure to check it out. It's free and it's really helpful. So next, we are just selecting the location where we want to save it. In that case, I want to save it in the sample output. And then we have to download the file with the document ID over here. In that case, we're not using the Google Docs module, but we're using the Google Drive module because that works with other file formats as well. And then there's one little trick, and that is turning on the advanced settings. You find that slider down here, and that is how it looks like by default. And you turn on the slider, and now you can select in which format you want to have files converted to. So Google Documents should be formatted into Word document, PDF, Open Office document, HTML, and so on. And we want to have it as PDF. You can do the same for Google Spreadsheets, for Google Slides, for Google Drawings to format them as Excel or even also as a PDF. Same for Google Slides that can be formatted as PowerPoint or PDF. And now the last step is that we actually upload it again to a specific folder to have it as a PDF file. Now let's look at this, let it run once and see what the outcome will look like. First, we're getting the data from our Google Sheet, which looks like this. Next, we are going to create the template, create the document from the template that we have there. We download the file to the make service basically, and then we upload it again to another folder on Google Drive. And this is how the final result looks like. We have the date in the name dynamically in the title of this document, a dash, and then this one is automatically dynamically generated as well with the first and last name of the customer. And then all the place, all the variables are replaced with the actual values we wanted to insert here. So yeah, that's how you can dynamically generate a PDF. You can use it for anything like mentioned before. And now I want to show you one more thing, and that is what you can do with this as well. Of course, you can just send it off to your customers directly via email as an email attachment, for example. That's very handy when you're dealing with invoices or contracts and these kind of things where you want to attach a PDF attachment from a document. And it's the same concept. So we are getting the data from our Google Sheet. Again, we are filtering by my name. Then we create the document from a template. Here, I just added this with email in the title. So we kind of have a differentiator to the previous example, and the data is not in here. And then we download the file again with the advanced settings as PDF. And then we use this send an email module. There's also an email if you're not using Gmail. You can also use the regular email module or an Outlook module. It works the same for all email providers. And then you put the email address here, the subject line and the content. And then you simply map as an attachment the downloaded file here from the Google Drive. And the way it looks like now is that we're searching the row, getting the data, we're creating another document here, we're downloading the file and then sending it off via email. So checking the emails, it looks like this over here. There's this email for you, and we have this email attachment with manual gig with email here, which is a PDF, dynamically generated PDF document. I hope you like this, and make sure to check out the description, download our make function cheat sheet to get more ideas of how you can dynamically transform the data, and watch out for more videos that we are uploading very soon about automation. Like and subscribe to our channel so we can provide you more content. Thank you very much for watching, and stay tuned for more.